called.
And do you think that
Little Feta, Fozok, Little Trailer.
The use of muti, a Zulu word that refers to witchcraft and traditional medicine, is commonplace in South Africa. People here turn to it for health and good fortune, but also to serve up bad luck to enemies and foes. Materials for muti's potions and spells can be found in places like this, the Faraday Market in central Johannesburg. Look one way and you'll see stacks of herbs and bottles of chalky liquids. Look another, and there's an elephant trunk, a rhinoceros leg, and a pair of cow hooves. Traditional diviners and herbalists, called sangomas and nyangas, carefully guard their recipes. Some traditional healers say World Cup fans have been coming to them in recent weeks for a competitive edge. One Sangoma offers a powder that fans can burn and blow at their beloved team to ensure victory. Others have remedies that could help the athletes themselves. Earlier this year, the medical committee of FIFA expressed concerns that some traditional remedies might include performance-enhancing stimulants, but the matter was left to local authorities. The South African Institute for Drug-Free Sport says any stimulants used in muti can't be detected in standard doping tests, and that the ingredients are hard to come by. The South African national team, known here as Bafana Bafana, has denied having anything to do with muti. But trainers like Tando McCall, who has worked with top-ranked players, say muti is used at all levels of the sport in South Africa, from casual weekend games to top-flight teams.
You look at all the teams in the country, they do that. Muti will always be there in our soccer standard, no matter how professional our game will be.
Fellow instructor Sakile Ngai says that muti is prevalent even at the youth level. One time, he recalls, when he was a young athlete at an amateur club, his team began losing and the coach ordered all of the players to turn in their cleats. When the shoes were returned, the muti was right there, he says, plain as day.
They had all sorts of markings inside and out with something that's white, sort of like chalk or something like that. Cool stuff. Went into a match, we won. Guess what? We thought, you know what, this is the way to go.
In fact, even the diviners and healers say muti alone cannot perform miracles. Only God can do that. But believing in the magic can work wonders. Indeed, with South Africa facing stiff competition over the next few weeks, many fans are hoping a bit of traditional muti will do the trick, wherever it comes from.
I don't know any sangoma right now, but if I know one, I would have gone there a long time ago. Because you know, I really want this trophy to remain here in South Africa.
It's about how much we believe in it, that probably work or not. But hopefully it will this time around, because we need the trophy to stay in Africa.
For the Wall Street Journal, this is Noah Rosenberg in Johannesburg, South Africa.
This is West Africa, birthplace of the talking drum, which leads us on a journey through soccer, science, and sorcery.
Africa is notoriously religious.
The African is notoriously music. I want you to see that too.
Immediately you hear the palombo playing, it draws people near. People enjoy themselves, sing together, dance together, play together. It's a social music. You can play in any ceremony, party, like adoring, soccer, on a pitch, wherever. It's very supportive.
Music is employed to invoke the presence of the gods or the presence of spirits. It is also used to induce a kind of a religious state of mind.
You actually use the drum to trigger off possession. Each god is represented by a different rhythm. So when a certain rhythm is played, the person is already slightly primed to become entranced. But there are actually rhythmic tricks. And sometimes they go off the rhythm. And sometimes they will go off the rhythm with the dancer and then stop in midair. And the person is left hanging. And that's when the ego can sort of evaporate in that moment.
If in the culture you have a particular music or song or particular way of producing music with drums, and that is the culture, and it's different from another culture that you're playing against, so it can be focused uniquely on the one team, that is going to have a massive effect.
When the right type of music is played, they are ready now. And they are possessed and they speak the future of the people. They say a lot of things.
The best players of Ghana, look how far we went. So it's our time.
In this country, whenever Ghana was going to play, Christians prayed in their churches, Muslims prayed, people who believed in indigenous religions or what people may call voodoo also did their own rituals, and they expected positive results.
It happens. In Ghana, I would say about more than 60% of the teams believe in this.
People who do voodoo are evildoers. They are heartless, they don't care about anything. They are not easily accepted.
There are many players I used to maybe spiritualists or something like that. Mm-hmm. I know Liberty, if they catch you, they'll sack you.
Here in West Africa, rhythm and ritual is as common as a game of soccer. Our journey to get behind the science of these mysteries continues.